Hi dear students, welcome back to chemistry class. So today we will see a new topic, that is evaporation. It's from the same chapter, matter in our surroundings, and it is the almost we can say we have reached the end of the chapter. Today's topic is evaporation. So evaporation, it is the process in which a substance change its physical state from liquid to gas. The substance change its state from liquid to gas, that is called what? Evaporation. Then we have studied the same definition for another process, right? In the previous classes we have studied the term that we used for conversion of liquid into gas. What is that? It is, are you remembering? It is boiling, right? It is boiling or vaporization. Okay, boiling or vaporization, that is the term we have used in our previous classes for the conversion from liquid to gas. Then now I have told you evaporation means what? The process of conversion of liquid to gas. So definitely you have a question, evaporation and boiling both are same. What do you think? Of course, they are not same. Evaporation and boiling both are different process. But generally what happen means in evaporation as well as in boiling, the change is from liquid to gas. So in evaporation, in addition to the boiling, there is a difference. So what does this means? We know boiling occurs at a particular temperature. Each substance is having its own boiling point. And when it reaches to that temperature, then only boiling occurs, right? So water, its boiling point will be 100 degrees Celsius. For water, it is 100 degrees Celsius. So when the temperature reaches at 100 degree, then only the water will start boiling, right? So boiling means the conversion from liquid to gas at its boiling point. Okay, but coming to the process evaporation, okay. Coming to the process evaporation, it is the transformation from or conversion from liquid to gas, but the speciality is that below the boiling point, okay, below the boiling point. So students, note down the change. Boiling means what? The conversion from liquid to gas at its boiling point, but evaporation, liquid to gas, change is same from the same phase. Conversion from liquid to gas, but below its boiling point. So we can say the major difference between boiling and evaporation. One is boiling at its boiling point, but evaporation below its boiling point. That is the first difference. And second one, we can say this boiling. Boiling is a bulk phenomenon. Boiling is bulk phenomenon because when a water, a certain amount of water is boils, it do not occurs only on the surface. The bulk, the entire water is what happened. Entire water molecules is boiling, right? But coming to the process evaporation, evaporation is a surface phenomenon. Evaporation is a surface phenomenon. That means, suppose if I have taken some water, if I have taken some water in this beaker, then what happened is that due to evaporation, liquid will change to what? Gas, right? So here, we cannot say all the liquid particles do not change to gaseous form. Only the particles which present in the surface, will escape. Okay, the particles which present in the surface will convert to the gaseous form, and that is why we will say evaporation is a surface phenomenon. But coming to the boiling means, not only this particles on the surface, every water molecules will what happen? They will boil. But evaporation means it is meant for only the particles which present in the surface. Okay, and now let's see how this evaporation, how the process is occurs and why it happened only for the molecules present in the surface. Okay, so let's see that. So for that, I told you the particles which present in the surface only escapes into gaseous form. Okay, so here what happened is that these particles present in the surface will collide each other. They are in continuous Brownian or zigzag motion. So what happened? They were almost always they are collide each other. So by colliding each other, it will gain a surface energy. It will gain a surface energy. Particles will gain an energy by this continuous collision, and that energy will be, and this energy gained by the collision will be greater than the intermolecular attraction. Intermolecular attraction. Okay, so students, note down the point. So by the continuous collision of particles of the surface, okay, that molecules, it gains an energy, and when that energy is overcomes the intermolecular force of attraction, because we know each particles they were attracted by an intermolecular force of attraction, right? So when this colliding energy, that energy gained by the collision, is overcomes this force, what happens? The particles can easily escapes out. Okay, and thus we will say evaporation is occurs. So suppose this beaker is an open beaker, right? So here it is exposed to air. So the collision is occurs between liquid-liquid collision and liquid, and it can be collide with the air particles too. So two types of collision occurs for a water which is present in this container. So we can list down the difference between evaporation and boiling. So the first one, evaporation is occurs below the boiling point. Okay, but boiling means at the boiling point, at its boiling point. And second one, for evaporation means evaporation is a surface phenomenon. Evaporation is a surface phenomenon, but boiling means it is a bulk phenomenon. That is what the second property we have discussed now. And the major difference is that if you are taking 100 ml water on boiling, and suppose the same water that we have kept for the process of evaporation, okay, and we know the evaporation is a slow process, it will be a time consuming process. We can't see we can't see any decrease in the water level even after 5 minutes or 10 minutes or even after 1 hour, right? So evaporation will take a time, more time compared to the process boiling. So that also we can write, evaporation is a slow process, but boiling means which is more fast. Okay, and we can now just discuss some of the examples, some examples for evaporation. Okay, so suppose if we are washed our clothes, if we washed our clothes, definitely we will hang them for drying, right? In the open air, we will hang those dresses for drying up. And there we know the water is converted to what? Water, liquid present in the cloth will convert it to water vapor, right? And we can say there is no boiling occurs. Generally, with our previous knowledge, we will say conversion from liquid to gas is what? Boiling. But actually the clothes is boiled? Of course not. But that water is escapes from the clothes. So there actually the phenomenon, the process occurs in such case is what? Evaporation. Okay. At the same time, just assume how we will get rain. Okay. So how we will get rain? So we know it is due to the water cycle. The water from the ocean, what happen? Ocean is evaporates. We cannot see when we will look to the seashore. From the seashore, when we will observe the ocean, means we can't see the water is escapes into the air, right? But there is evaporation. There evaporation has happened, right? So due to this evaporation, what happened? Cloud formation occurs, and finally it will transform into what? Rain. Okay, so that also we can say another example for this evaporation. again we can say many examples for evaporation, but it is all this process compared to the next one, boiling, but it will be a little bit slow process. Okay, and again, just imagine the water that we have taken in an earthen pot. Okay, so in a pot, the water taken in pot. So there we know the process of evaporation is actually occurring there. And how evaporation occurs in a water that is taken in an earthen pot, how the water gets evaporates, because that pot, suppose this is a pot. This is a pot and in which I have taken water, the pot which contains water. And the speciality of this pot is made from what? It's made from soil or particular a clay, right? So this pot contains number of minute pore. This pot contains number of minute pores were present. So through that pore, what happened? The water molecules will escapes out. Through the pores of that pot, this water molecules will escapes out. So due to through this surface, it collides with the surface. The particles present in this near to the surface will collide each other, and finally they escapes out through the pore space present in this earthen pot. Okay, so that also an example for what? Evaporation. Okay. So dear students, we have discussed some examples for evaporation. Again, there are many examples. So please list down the examples for evaporation that you have seen in your daily life. Okay, that you can copy to your notebook, different examples for evaporation. So today we discussed a new concept, that is evaporation, which is entirely different from boiling. Even though the same phase change occurs, one is occurs at its boiling point, but other one occurs below its boiling point. Okay, so remember all the postulates or properties of the properties regarding this evaporation, and get ready for the live session. See you in the next class, and thank you for watching.